I'm going to be doing a review on a Web3 protocol called Cypherium today, all right? This is blown up all over online, so we've got to do a review for you. So let's get straight into this after this disclaimer. I'm not a financial advisor. I do this for education purposes only. So let's rock and roll the tape. So here you go, guys, over at Cypherium.io, okay, as it says, a Web3 ready blockchain, bringing CBDC, DeFi, and Web3 through protocol interoperability. Now, you can subscribe for the newsletter straight away, but I want to give you a bit of an overview of what this even is. So it's an instant ledger to process real-time transactions, okay, for billions of users. A smart contract platform to enable enterprises use cases for all industries. A trusted database to connect CBDCs, digital assets, and dApps around the world. A whole open network to enfranchise any participant or contributor, and a secure vault to combat the increasing threats to data privacy. Now, by providing a truly decentralized and scalable framework, combined with an accessible and intuitive user interface, Cypherium lays a comprehensive foundation for developers to create groundbreaking apps capable of transforming the future of the business, law, and enterprise solution. Using a hybrid consensus mechanism that utilizes both proof of work and hot stuff, the blockchain is designed to achieve commercialization viability by maximizing both decentralized and scalability without sacrificing one or the other. Unlike many second and third generation blockchains, the abandoned Satoshi Nakamoto's original permissionless, trustless, consensus mechanism, Cypherium is built on the valuable innovations of previous blockchains. I want you to go and watch this video on their website. Okay, I'm not going to play it all for you right now because it's 3 minutes 30 seconds long. But what I want you to see is this gives you a real nice insight to exactly what this project is bringing and the vision about what this project is trying to achieve, okay? So please go on there and do me a massive favor. If you take anything from this video, watch that. It will tell you a lot about the project. Now, they're engaging with world leaders of financial industry all of the time, okay? So please, please go and read all of the blogs in here talking about all the tools they have, the Cyberlink, the Cypherium Connect, the Cypherium Validator, the ID for the decentralized ID authentication, all their features, okay? Real-time intermediary to replace the inefficient legacy interbank communication system and to connect digital assets all around the world. It's ICO 2022 compliant and can seamlessly be embedded with the current financial system. This is, like they say, the season of killer apps, all right? We've already shifted a focus from general consensus about thousands of TPS blockchain trilemma or sharding to real killer apps, which are considered by the holy grail of blockchain. So who actually are they? Okay, we know exactly what this does, what it's about, but who are they? All right, blockchain solutions, which have full stack blockchain integration solution for enterprise from small to large sizes, cloud consultation, comprehensive blockchain SaaS consortium by their world-class exports, and software licenses with the premium support from their team by purchasing the enterprise license. The ecosystem consists of huge names such as Microsoft, Randstad, DMI, Google Cloud, IBM, IC3, AWS, okay? And they are in the news every single day. It's ridiculous how well this project is carrying itself. So we know what it is, we know who it is, we know the vision, but how exactly do the moving parts work with this dual chain structure and hybrid consensus? So here's the process, okay? It's a mining in traditional proof of work protocols like Bitcoin. It takes on two related yet distinct functions. First, mining involves electing a leader who's responsible for generating the newest block. You can see this from the diagram down here, okay? And the second function consists of verifying the transaction data that exists within the block body. So however, there is nothing inherently beneficial about using a single process to complete both of these actions. Cypherium's technology separates these two processes into two distinct blockchains. In order to improve the efficiency of both, an election chain chooses proof of work leaders to write new blocks, while a transaction chain uses hot stuff consensus to verify the transaction data within these blocks. So you can see it here with the voting committee going all the way down, all the way to the mining side, okay? Now a peek inside to the ecosystem, how it works. The leader node proposes a block and waits to be verified by the validating nodes. If 2 out of 3 of the quorum is reached, the block is accepted into the blockchain. Now following its acceptance, the new block is then broadcasted to all nodes, and to be honestly verified, the nodes will then reject all messages from nodes without POW. Okay, this is how Cypherium achieves the unprecedented scalability by electing the voting committee to separate POW from the transaction verification process. Now, you get so many benefits with this. You get reduced security effects, faster transaction, no minimum charge of smart contract, and no fixed block size, okay? The initial mainnet offering, okay, is actually ready to launch. But please, please do your own research and get involved right now. There you go, guys. If you enjoyed the video, do me a favor, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit the bell if you want to be notified, and I'll see you on the next video.